Michigan State. I want to talk about their rotation. They dropped the practice video yesterday. It was electric. I'm not going to front. I do not root for Michigan State basketball. I alluded to it. I am a guy who will overreact to offseason practice videos. I think people make fun of me for this a lot. They're like, oh, Greg's just overreacting at everything again. I want to give an official statement on that. If you're a basketball fan, man, enjoy basketball. Why would we not overreact to things? Like, the Michigan State just gave us this awesome video where Tyson Walker's in a headband and Jaden Akin's in cornrows and everybody's flying around dunking on everyone to the point they had to hide the face of who Xavier Booker crammed on. But I did my body language PhD and deciphered exactly who it was, and I might reveal it later in this segment. Point is, I'm going to overreact, man. That's way more fun. It's not fun to be a college basketball fan who just shrugs everything off and is like, well, nothing matters until the games get here. Like, no, this is a year-round sport. I'm going to enjoy the thing I love more than anything in my family that's not my wife and daughter, okay? Let me live. And today we're going to overreact to Michigan State because the video was awesome. That's your team. This team looks incredible on paper. I love the vibes. I love the body language. I love everything about this team on paper. Now, Izzo was asked some questions, and he gave the typical coach speak answers, but there's one thing I picked out that's very intriguing to me. He said he intends to play 11 players, and he's done this before. That's a thing that works for Michigan State. We've spent 3 years saying he's playing too many players. He's got to trim the rotation. This year, I think there's a lot of guys who do deserve minutes. But if you go up and down the list card, 11 is a lot. And 11 likely includes at least one guy that I don't think deserves minutes. So let's dive into that a little bit. What does 11 guys mean for Michigan State basketball this season?
So obviously, you know, following Michigan State basketball, one of the greatest pastimes is literally attempting to play all 12 players on the team to at least start the season, no matter what. That's one of the greatest pastimes of Michigan State basketball. It's probably forever going to be that way. There's going to be funky rotations come around January, February. That's just how the program operates, whether we're good or we're bad. I think you kind of hit the nail on the head. Last year, it was frustrating, or in previous years, it's frustrating when you try to go 11 deep or 10 deep and you don't actually have the talent to do that. So if this team ends up going like 9 to 10 deep, I actually think there's 9 to 10 players that probably warrant minutes on this basketball team. 11 is a little bit of a stretch, I think. I don't think that's going to last too long. I think he just said 11 off the top of his head. So I'm not too concerned about it. Those type of things also work themselves out as well once actual games come around. But I think it's safe to say, and you should feel good as a Michigan State fan, that this team actually has the talent on paper to play that many players. 11 might be a stretch, but I feel confident saying like 9 to 10 guys deserve to get minutes on this team. And one more thing I want to comment on. Coach Izzo said in his press conference, this is Coach Speak 101 right here, that the thing that he's concerned most about this team right now is leadership and shot selection. Let me translate that for you. We are nasty. Okay, that's the I can't find anything else to say bad about my team. So I'm gonna go to the safe route here. I'm gonna say leadership and shot selection. We are nasty. Everyone should feel amazing right now. If you want to talk about overreacting, it's time to overreact. The minute I saw Graham Couch tweet that little excerpt, that little tidbit right there, I was like, let me go ahead and double down on my Final Four future. Because if leadership's the issue and shot selection is what he's saying on the first day of practice, we are nasty.
I had to laugh at that. Yeah, you're worried about leadership 5 seconds after you just compare Jeremy Fears to a Mateen Cleaves-esque leader on a team that starts fourth year, fifth year, third year, fifth year, third year. I don't think leadership should be a problem. You're probably right on that. He called out a couple other things briefly that, again, minor concerns in my opinion, but they apply more to how good Michigan State will actually be. Like, he talked about not having a post scorer. They weren't a great team at scoring from inside last year. Jaden Akins was a part of that. Like, he just hasn't been a good finisher in his career, even though all reasons of him as a basketball player should make him a good finisher. So it'll be interesting. 'Cause, like, you know, they definitely have lob threats now. They definitely have guys who can fly around. And Cohen Carr and Xavier Booker are going to play. Where they play is interesting to me, and it goes back to his we're going to play 11 guys thing. Because if you go up and down the roster, there's 12 scholarship players in this roster, I believe, correct?
Yes.
I believe that's correct. So the 12 guys, if we're going up and down, who's going to play and who might not? A.J. Hogard, Tyson Walker, Jaden Akins, Malik Hall, Mati Sissoko are going to play. Jeremy Fears is going to play backup minutes. Xavier Booker and Cohen Carr are going to get on the court. That's 8 guys. Then you're left with revolving door centers, which includes Jackson Kohler and Carson Cooper. And then you're left with 5th guard, Trey Holloman, and the other freshman, Garrick Normand. I believe that's the 12 players on this team. So... Mm-hmm. If Izzo was just kind of doing a like, hey, we're going to play everybody thing, I think he could have just said, yeah, we might play 12. He didn't do that. So I think there is an element of like, oh, I've been scoping this out and I intend to have an 11-man rotation. And I'm curious who that 11th guy is, because I think he's going to play all the centers. I think he's going to play Cooper and Kohler no matter what. I don't think he's satisfied with whoever a starting center is, and he might mix Booker in, but they got 4 guys that could play center minutes. I think he intends to either play one of Holloman or Normand and not play the other. And I know what I would do between those two. I want to know what you would do between those two.
I play Normand. And this is not a Normand versus Trey argument in my eyes. This is where I'm coming from on this one. I don't want Trey's minutes to eat into Jeremy Fears' minutes. I don't want Trey's minutes to eat into Jaden Akins playing some minutes at the one or the two. Like, I don't want that to be eaten into. And, you know, just looking at it from a basketball skill standpoint of what they do well, this team's biggest question mark is who's going to be the shooters. Like, you have Jaden Akins, you have Tyson Walker, you lose Joey Hauser. Norman's a guy who comes in with the label as a shooter. So if a team that needs shooting has a guy and you're deciding a team that needs shooting and you're deciding who that 11th guy is, you might lean towards a guy who actually, you know, is the better shooter of the two players. But then again, you know, Izzo might be thinking, I want the guy who's maybe a more dynamic defender. And I know that all the reports are that, Gary's got a long way to come defensively. Trey Holloman at worst, I think, could be a really good defensive guy. So, you know, I don't really know, but right now, based on the team's needs, I would leave Normand being that guy.
Okay. Yeah. I think like Norman's path to me is like, if the team needs shooting, is he a shooter? And I think he is. I've talked about it. I think he's a shooter with size and some shit to him. And I do have questions. Like, Cohen Carr can't shoot. We want him on the floor. Xavier Booker, we don't know how well he can shoot, even though he wants to drift to the perimeter sometimes. Malik Hall, like, we don't know. We think he is a good shooter on paper, but we don't know. Like, if all of those guys are like 33% three-point shooters or worse, then I think there's a path to Norman just out of necessity of maybe needing a fourth shooter on the floor. But to me, like, 5 guards is too many guards. And I don't know how much we're going to do just Michigan State week-to-week talk this year. We'll obviously talk about it on the show because we're doing daily episodes and that's going nowhere. And we've done Unscripted, the podcast, in the past. I think we still need to determine what that is going to look like this year, because I don't want that to disappear for Michigan State fans the moment their team gets good after the last 2 years. But we just haven't figured that out logistically yet. Point is, if that exists, you're going to hear me all season long saying 5 guards is too many guards. No good team should be playing 5 guards. You just shouldn't. And I get that, like, Akins.
But what if we're playing 3 guards, though?
That's what I'm saying. I get that you're playing 3 guards and Akins is at the 3, whatever. You could just do what you're doing with 5 guards with 4, though. Like, there is no reason that Holloman needs minutes unless he proves that he deserves them. And maybe he will, right? Like, I know I've essentially written him off, but as far as I know, from everything I have seen about him as a player this summer and all the incoming guys, he's not better than any of the other 4. He's not better at anything than Jaden Akins. He's not better at anything than Jeremy Fears. Maybe defense, we got to see. But on paper, I want Fears, Akins, Hogard, and Walker to get all of the minutes. If there's 120 minutes available and those guys are playing 1, 2, and 3, I want those split up between those four guys. I don't even want Holloman to be on for 5 minutes because I think it's pointless. I think you've got four guys that can play it. And realistically, like, you're going to sprinkle in Carr or Normand at the three a little bit, or Malik Hall down at the three. So to me, it's just too many. Five is too many. And I think that's what Izzo was intending to do with this. I don't think he was like, hey, we might play 11 and Normand might be one. I think it's much more likely like Holloman's my guy. He's in the rotation. And that's notable for me because I don't think he needs to be, but we'll come back to it. Bottom line is you should be really excited. This team's going to be nasty, man.
Yeah, 100%. And one last thing I want to add, and I hate to do this, and I hate to be this guy, but you kind of got me on the overreacting train a little bit. I do think that it actually holds some weight, no pun intended, that Jay Nakins actually added like 10 pounds, if he did. Because I think a lot of what he struggled with at the rim was because of his strength and his weight.
Okay. Yeah, maybe.
Mati Sissoko putting on 25 pounds. Now I don't really know what that's going to do.
I don't care about offseason weight updates at all. I do not care. Unless a guy went from like...
What about losing weight?
Yeah, if a guy went from like 320 to 280 and he's a center, then, oh, wow, he really got in shape. But like, oh, sorry, the point guard that you play at the three added 10 pounds? Whoa, that really shifts shit for me now, huh? Like... Rothstein was like, sources out of East Lansing say Mati Sissoko has added 20 pounds. He's really added muscle. You idiot. Like, muscle has not been the problem. Has he added basketball instincts? Has he been on the jug machine? Like, it's driving me insane, man. But I don't know. Y'all are going to be nasty. That's my takeaway. Like, overreact guy, this team's fun, first and foremost, whether or not
that fears Dime to Booker to him just. I need it, man. Like, the
who he dunked on, right?
Maddie's not doing that. He's not.
No, of course not. You know who he dunked on, right?
Was it Cooper?
No.
Was it Jackson?
It was Jax.
Damn.
Yeah, I did the body language investigative search this morning, and they had different accessories on. You could tell who was who. It was Jax.
Okay, well, let me flip this narrative then. Would have been more impressive if it was on Cooper, but maybe Booker has that dog in him. Got sick of everybody talking about how Kohler had that 50 ball. So any chance he gets in practice, he's punching on Kohler.
I just think it's this. Like, if that was any of the other three centers and they catch a no-look dime with 2 feet on the ground and somebody just actually walling you up, Mati's fumbling that, dribbling three times, and then kicking out. Carson Cooper might try to dunk it, but he's probably losing the ball on the way up or getting fouled or something. Kohler is like taking it, collecting himself, doing three shimmies and attempting a fadeaway hook. Like, Xavier Booker just caught that shit, wasn't rattled, had someone guarding him and dunked on his head. Like, that is an element Michigan State hasn't had. And I get, like, you go back through the A.J. Hogard years, man. He's one of the best passers in the country. He always has been. He's been throwing the ball to Julius Marble, Marcus Bingham, who couldn't even stay on the floor, Joey Hauser, Thomas Kithier, and now Carson Cooper, Mati Sissoko, and Jackson Cole. He's never had a lob threat. He's never had a guy who can just dunk the basketball. Now he has two of them.
I needed that lob threat at the end because I didn't like Joseph Jamal being in that list.
No, just like he had six plotting centers and Marcus Bingham, whose lungs were filled with so many non-good things at all times. Like, it's going to be eye-opening, I think. Anyone who's skeptical of what Booker and Carr can do are going to get awakened quickly when they just realize they don't even need to be anything special to just run and dunk. And that's going to open so much up for Hogard and everybody else by default. So yeah, y'all are going to be good. It's going to be fun. I'm excited for Michigan State basketball. Contrary to popular belief, I like it when you guys are good because, one, I like watching good basketball, and to me, it makes this whole rivalry element of this way more fun, and the Big Ten needs it. So I'm looking forward to it. This is the most excited I've been for a Michigan State season since the probably the sophomore year of redacted Josh Langford, Cassius Winston.
Yep, same. Yeah, very excited.
All right, final topic today.